you don't go in there.
Okay, I know she's a fast mover. Sorry, we just had a little interruption there because I wanted to make sure the sound was on. She just hissed at Maggie, who was running by in a hurry. I think it was her, not Maggie, but I don't know. One of them hissed. See what's out there? You just smelling. Just gotta make sure it's locked. You're sorry. Oh, that was a hiss from a long way away for Custard, but at least he listened. That's fine. That's the same way that Nibbles started hissing from very far away, making sure everybody stayed very far away, and then slowly relaxing her limits until yesterday she's headbutting with Loganberry. Custard, be careful now. She's saying she doesn't know about you yet. You're being a good boy, though. Okay, I'm sorry. Good job. Smart. You seem like you're getting a little frantic, kiddo. Do you want to go back up to your kittens now? I see your tail's really going, just like Nibbles used to. You're still super friendly to the walls, aren't you? I love all the walls and the television. Not the other cats, though. I guess you can probably hear when she hisses. That was a little hiss for a goblet there. But again, it was just one of those stay back hisses, not one of those I'm going to attack you hisses. Which is good, again. Just like Nibbles. you know how to get home when you're ready? And you're just trying to figure out how to get outside to those birds. This is not a door. I know it looks like a door. I mean, I guess technically it is a door. It doesn't go outside though. Carpet cleaner's still out from when I cleaned the second annex yesterday. I was letting it dry over here on the rug. Come on now, I'm not going to film you hanging out in the toilet. Want the food? Do you want to come up here? There's nobody up here now. Come here. It's okay, Ari's like, I know how this goes. I'm gonna run away, write me out. Come here, buddy, it's all right. Can I pet you? Hi, I know, you're a good boy. She'll be your friend soon. Just like the other mom is already. Well, if you're done at the bird feeder, I bet she would love to see the bird feeder. Can I show her? Come with me. I bet you wanted to see this anyway. Oh, you don't have to hiss at him from up here. Here, what's that? Oh, there's a squirrel right there. Do you see him? Do you see him? You don't see him? Well, I thought you would really like seeing this squirrel, but You don't seem to be paying attention to that at all. You like some cats. I heard her jump down, so did he. There we go. Oh, good, he's not even gonna stop kneading on his favorite bed. Uh-oh, if you smell something there, it's probably bad news, huh? I guess that'll be smell. Nope, you're just smelling the furs? Okay, good. Kiddo, I need second coffee, and I can't stop to make it while you're running around for your first time out. I see you're already learning where you can go, though. I also should restart this stream, because if I go longer than a half an hour, the robots automatically pretend that it's a mailbag. Maybe we should just put a little gap. Do you know how to get back upstairs? You haven't gone to the front of the house for a while. Going to be a very long micro tomorrow. Oh, is she going to jump up on the counter? Whoa, she thought about it. Good, that was bold though. Nibbles, I don't think Nibbles did that until she was invited to. She had to learn what was up there first. Or maybe I'm thinking of Thimble was here right before Nibbles, right? Maybe she's the one that didn't go until she was invited. Some mom cats never get on the counter, and other mom cats get on there all the time. If she's jumping up there to check it out the first day, though, I think she's going to be an all-the-time one. Well, she didn't get mad at seeing the kittens playing. So I think she's not going to mind too much activity, but, you know, obviously she's a little on edge because it's her first time out. Are you just going to sit here, huh? In the middle of the floor, own the space, and watch some birds? She saw me petting him and she didn't respond, so that's already progress. But I know she's not going to want him getting too close, and I think he knows that too. Careful now, don't sneak up on him. That would be your fault. I bet there's a lot to smell over here where the kittens play all day. I'm always suspicious when there's a long sniff. Maybe there's a little too much to smell there. I'll go smell that curtain. Don't start anything with those kids. No, it smells good to me. It's nice that she clearly is not out to start any trouble. Even though you can tell she's a little agitated because you can see her tail going. She's agitated, but she's obviously just on edge, you know, because it's a new place. And she's been checking it out for an extended amount of time. It's got to help her a little bit that I'm here, though. You know how this works? Do you have one of these in your room? You probably don't want to play right now, do you? Don't come all the way over here, Maggie. Not if you know what's good for you. Good. Maggie's going to take a wide turn around to get to me. Now you're kind of blocked from the only door, aren't you? How do you feel if you have to run past Maggie? Aren't you pretty? I think she realizes that Custer just laid down and isn't actually all that interested in her. Uh-oh. But she and Maggie both just started moving at the same time, and that seems like a coincidence, but kind of a threatening one. Okay, good. That's good. Now's her chance. You want to follow me back upstairs? Relieve me either way. You know how to get back over here? Your kids are up here, sweetie. You know that. Let's go. Right here. You ready to go back in? Your breakfast's in there. So are your kids. They need some breakfast, too. Nice job. I'm going to go get some coffee now. Let me show you. Just choosing to go back in your room doesn't mean you lose access to me. There you go. Okay, hi, sweetie. Okay. Okay, but I gotta go get that coffee though, it's important.